here in this hallowed assembly, this hallowed hall. Things have changed a lot since 1981 when I was here. It is beautiful. So thank you for Colonel Benson, Dr. Britt, all his teachers, staff, alumni, and most of all you, the poor cadets. Thank you for having me here. I don't think I've spoken all over the country. I don't think I've ever seen such a display before an opening ceremony of a talk. So I'm really blessed to be here and really excited about sharing with you. So thank you for having me. Today I wanted to speak. Today I wanted to speak. You know this motto? You seen it?
Yes, sir.
I didn't think much of it while I was here, I have to admit. It's one of those things I just heard of in the back, right? The back of my mind, the transcripts of my mind. But as I've gotten older, I've reflected on it. And I hadn't been here on campus in about 15 years, and I came last April with a bunch of buddies of mine, and I was very impressed. And I got reacquainted with the motto. So, mens sana in corpore sano, healthy minds. Healthy bodies, healthy minds. And you do that every day, every single day. And don't take that for granted. Because there's lots of people in this big world of ours that can't do that. I want to talk about something else. I'm going to add to our motto here. I'm concerned. I'm going to move away from this. Is it still on? You here?
Yes, sir.
I'm concerned about developing our hearts. And not a heart for exercise, but our internal hearts. Our internal lives, cultivating our internal lives. I think that's probably the most important thing. I want you to think about your core values, your passion in life. Not too early to start thinking about those things. So I want to talk about five ways to do this. The title of this talk, I titled Building Character the Old-Fashioned Way, Five Ways of Traveling the Road Less Traveled. So I want to talk about traveling this road less traveled. Famous quote, we'll talk about that towards the end. So five ways here I want to talk about. I'm concerned again about developing our interior life. Okay. Keep skipping a slide here. Too long. Well, you can see up here, these are five areas that I want to talk about. Some of them you're already probably engaged in. So I'll talk about the golden rule, a moral compass, right? Determination, discipline, cultivating your spirituality, and serving one another. This is one I'm sure everyone knows about, the golden rule. So in my profession, I teach theology. And this is at the core base of everything that I believe as a theologian, everything that I believe as a person, even the things that I was taught here when I was sitting where you were 30 years ago. So love God and love neighbor. That's the basis of our foundation as human beings. That's what God has created us to be. To love God and to love neighbor. That's the first thing. It sounds a lot easier than it is, because it's easy to love God, which we can't see. It's easy to love our friends. It's easy to love our brothers and sisters and our family. But we're called to love our neighbor as well. And that means sometimes loving people who rub us the wrong way, get on our nerves, maybe irritate us once in a while. That's where the real challenge is. So love God, love me. This is something that I think is instilled in me here very early in life, like you and I hear, you cadets. Develop your moral compass. What does it mean to be moral? Thinking, someone shut out. What's morality?
Do the right thing.
Do the right thing. What else? Something else.
Be honest.
Being honest. Okay? So you have these up here. Right? These traits. Remain, try to maintain some honesty in your life, not once in a while, all the time. So I'm a father of three, as you heard in my bio. I'm always telling my kids and my students, right? We are called to live up here. We're called to fly up here high. Most of us fly right around here. We want to still aim high. Be honest. Tell the truth. Do the right thing. I coach wrestling. And one of the things I can tell boys is, right, say what you mean and mean what you say. I learned that here. Say what you mean what you say. In life, that's it. Goes a long way. So when you start to hang around, my dad used to have a slug, I'll clean it up for you. He drill it in our heads, he used to say to us, right? You hang around quality people, that's what you'll become. You'll become a quality person. So, if you don't hang around quality people, then you might not be quality yourself. So, part of this I like to talk about too is something called the ethic of caring. Develop an ethic, a lifestyle, a passion for caring about others, to be fair and objective, and I've learned that here. How to be fair with people when you're dealing with people, how to be objective. I can't just take one person's side of the story. I have to hear the other side. Because it's probably three sides to every story. So you have to discern what's fair, what's objective. Discerning. Here's one of the great ways to serve. Any athletes out there? So, one of the greatest things that I like to do, a lot of schools around the country have service projects, service hours they have to do. And I think that's important. But I want to develop a lifestyle of service, helping people in need. One of the things that I've been doing since I was 21, on and off my entire life, has been coaching. That's an excellent way to serve. Any seniors in the house? That's not too far off when I started, right? 21. Right? Seniors, right? So you can start now serving. You don't have to wait till you're older, you have enough money, or you have your college degree, or you set your career. One of the great ways of serving others, right? For me, it's been coaching. It's coaching, it's teaching. Helping people. I teach little bitty kindergartners, up to 8th grade, now I'm a college coach. And for me, that's the greatest joy. So you can become, get involved in some kind of service. Altruism, that's another word for kind of serving the community, volunteering, offering your time, your talent, your treasure to an activity. Another important thing about service, when I get freshmen in college come and take an intro class with me, I tell them, realize, and this is hard, realize that your life is not about you. Your life is bigger than you. Everything you do has consequences and affects somebody or something else. So the quicker you can realize that your life is not about you, it's about others, more success you're going to have in life. The less selfish you'll become. The more giving you'll become. One of the other parts that I think is important, besides service, is cultivating our spiritual side. Cultivating our interior life. When I was here, that wasn't talked a lot about. I don't know if that's changed a lot. Right? I was always in fear that my mom would know that I wasn't going to church on Sunday, so I'd always go. Right? Somehow I knew that she would know, so I took the bus into town, and a lot of times I took guys with me. And I never thought of myself as a real spiritual guy, right? But I always felt this was the right thing to do, right? Made mom happy, and I started at a very early age. start to cultivate this spiritual side of me?
Well, for me, where that starts is seeing the glass half full. Anybody heard that expression before? Seeing half glass full, half empty? Okay. I don't like it to be around someone who sees the glass half empty. I prefer to move away from that. I want to be around positive people, people that have an impact, people that see the glass half full. So this is part of developing your spiritual life. Part of Corsanum, developing a healthy heart, is developing your spiritual life. There are all kinds of ways to do that, a myriad of ways. The most common way that most of us do this is through prayer, through personal prayer. Whatever your God is, whatever faith tradition you are. So that's why I say we want to pray in all ways. All kinds of ways. Not just one way. Right? Buddhists pray one way. Muslims pray another way. Christians pray another way. Jews pray a different way. They're all good ways. So whatever it is, try to develop that interior life. Read a sacred text. The Quran, the Tikitaka, the Torah, the scriptures, whatever it is. Read a sacred text. Right? Something that will illuminate your mind. Other than academic stuff, sports stuff. Worship off campus. For me, when I was here, that was a great thing for me. I could go to people in my faith tradition, I could worship off campus, come back here, right on campus with my friends. Sometimes I take buddies with me. Get involved. People out there. And the last one in this area is make a holy pilgrimage, wherever that is. See here, I have a mosque up there, up on a slide. There's all kinds of holy places in this country. And if you ever get a chance to travel one day abroad, all kinds of holy places that you can make a pilgrimage, make a holy moment, a trip, and engage that holy side, that sacred side of your life. This is probably one of you guys as a core, you're going to agree with, right? That I see all kinds of students, right? I do a lot of pastoral counseling with folks at the university. And someone said to me, man, I met when students come to see you, they're homesick. I wish that were the case. I wish I saw more people who were homesick. It's a little more serious than that. People are hurt for no other reason than life is tough. I have not suffered a lot in my life. That's a major thing, but I've had it pretty good. Our canals have a pretty good life. I have nothing to complain about. I've not really faced any big tragedy other than people that have, loved ones that have died. Grit. You know what grit is? What's grit? What's grit? What's temerity? That's a good word for you guys. What's temerity? Huh?
You didn't learn how to
read. Temerity, right?
You use a different word.
Right? You gotta have grit, temerity.
This is what I learned from Coach Pizza.
Who are you?
The next two. Perseverance. Tenacity. Sticking to things. Committing to things. I was telling a buddy of mine when we drove over here yesterday that I'm the policy that I'm coaching is you're not going to be able to quit the rest of the team. You can't quit. Once you start, you can't quit. You're in. But maybe you can't start. Maybe you're going to be, you got two guys in weight class are better. Well, maybe you can coach. Coach a little pee-wee team, or maybe you can help coach. Another junior high down the street. So, perseverance, stick to things, tenacity, grabbing on. When I was working on my doctorate degree, my professor said, man, you're the most tenacious person I've ever seen. I said, thank you. Grab on to it, hold on to it, go after it, set a goal, stick to it, see it through. This is what I tell my boys, consistency over time gets results. My son, the sixth grade this year, he finished fourth in the county city championships in Indianapolis, the rest of it was state championships there. And he says, I really want to be good at that.
10,000. That's what it takes for family. You get good love single, or you get a fire to scare, you can do it 10,000 times. You want to be able to swing a baseball, hit it correctly, 10,000 times. You want to be a good quarterback, and I throw that ball, crack the receivers, 10,000 times. That's where you master from. That's the item in that science. 10,000 times, right? Consistency over time gives you results. Determination, discipline. That's what you guys are learning here. That's what you're living here. That's going to see you through for the rest of your life. So these are, for me, as I was thinking, right, about building character the old-fashioned way. What are the five ways of the road less traveled? Famous quote here from our prophet. Right? I saw a fork in the road, I took the one less traveled, right? The harder way. In the scripture, it talks about the high road. Right? I took the one less traveled, and it has made all the difference to me. My hope, my prayer, my encouragement to you is that you too will take the road less traveled when it comes to developing your character. Take the harder road, and I promise you, it will make all the difference in you as well. Thank you very much for having me.